A user asked for a roller for footsteps or fancy designs. I've got a technique, so let's get cracking. We're going to start our project in Tinkercad. You can find it at tinkercad.com. If this is your first time using Tinkercad, I always choose sign in with Google. Today we're going to hit create new 3D design. Now the question was, how do you take a cylinder and wrap a pattern like footsteps around it? Here's what I've got. We're going to hold down shift. We're going to stretch this to Crazyville, but then I'm going to tell you to type the number 60 and press enter. The user wanted the roller to be close to 2.5 inches. These numbers make it a little easier, and it's really close. We're going to start by taking the sides and maximizing them. Before we go any further, I'm going to change the name. That is usually step one for me. I'm going to call this quarter circle. Now we're going to use a real sweet technique to cut this out. Bring out your sketch tool and set it on one of the 20 by 20 grids. It'll jump in and we'll have to zoom way out. And we are going to create a box that leaves 1/4 of this in an instant. Start by clicking at the center, and we're just going to go up 30. Remember, this was 60 on a side. So if we go up 30, over 30, we have just got the part we want left. We can finish by just going up 30 this way, and then 60 over and 60 down. Making sure, of course, you keep it straight, and then finishing the shape. This will leave 1/4 of our circle. Simply finish sketch, and let's adjust some sizes. Instead of 60, I want this to be 30, because I don't need that large of a roller. Of course, this needs to be larger than the shape, and it needs to be a hole. Now we can select the two, choose L for align, snap it to middle, and middle. Once you've got them aligned, simply hit group, and we've got 1/4 of our circle. Now we can simply hit export, STL. I'm going to store mine in my downloads, and I'm going to put the word feet after it. Now the user wanted to make tracks. They could be paws, or it could be awesome glyphs that you find. Whatever pattern you find, simply track it down, and then save it as a PNG. Once you have your image, I like to use Pick SVG to upload the picture, and then simply open it. When it first shows up, it usually has edge 2. I prefer instead the filled in one. I use internal 2 almost exclusively. Once we've got that shape, we can then download the SVG. I'm going to put it in my downloads folder. I'm going to just change the name because I'd already saved it once before and hit save. The next part of this process happens in your slicer. I'm going to be doing this in the bamboo slicer. Let's simply grab that part. There is my quarter circle, and we want to add an image to this side. What we're going to do is right click, add part, and you guessed it, we want the SVG. Find my foot sand 2. As soon as it comes in, we want to click over here and choose use surface, and then we're going to make it much smaller. As it gets close to the right size, I'm going to rotate it to the correct angle. I'm going to change the thickness to 1 and press enter. That way it's at a good depth for the rest of the project. And we can grab that yellow dot and move it to the location where we want to put it. Notice I've almost got it so it fits. Let's check it out from every angle. Heck yeah! We have just made the quarter circle roller. Now we can simply click File and Export, and I want it to be 1 STL. I'm going to call it quarter circle, and I'm going to put the FT for foot. Of course, if you're making paw prints or hieroglyphs, you would name it that way. And now I have bounced back to Tinkercad. Let's choose import. Choose a file. In downloads, there's my quarter circle with the feet. I am going to keep the dimensions. And after a moment, there's our project. Here, my friends, is how we line it up. Control D. I'm going to do shift nudge to move it over, and then I simply rotate it 90 degrees. It's not quite perfect, so let's do shift nudge again. W for work plane, click where we want it to land, and hit D to drop. Now let's put the work plane back on the ground. Click on the 2, shift select, and do control D. And I am going to warn you, you do have to rotate them the 90 degrees. If you use the mirror tool, they'll be aimed the wrong way. Shift nudge, W for work plane, I'm going to grab those two and D to drop. W for work plane, and we'll put them in. So we've got this part created, but I want it to print even faster, so I'm going to cut out the middle. Let's grab another cylinder, shift stretch it. Notice this one's set as a hole. Our whole project was 60, so I'm going to do 55 and press enter. I'm going to grab these and do Control G to group. So that way I can now grab these two, choose L for align, and choose center and center. Of course, Control G, and we have got a roller that is going to make footprints. How cool is that? Export for 3D printing, STL. I'm going to store it in my 3D modeling folder, and I'm going to call it quarter circle, and I'll put the word feet after it. A quick return to Bamboo Lab Studio. I'm going to delete that one, and let's click add and grab that quarter circle with feet. I printed mine with 0.2 settings. If we hit slice plate, it only takes about 30 minutes to complete. And less than 30 minutes later, we've got footsteps. Now do note, see how I've got them aimed forward? For it to show up the way you want, you need to do it backwards when you roll them. Here we are, rolling footprints in clay. Bingo. How cool is that? As I wrap up, of course, now you've got a technique you can use to put any pattern on a cylinder for rolling into whatever you want. If you do choose to work with food, do make sure you find a food-safe material. I'm not an expert on that, so you'll have to rely on Google or someone else. I also want to thank Freedomist Man for the question. And of course, I want to thank everybody that's part of my YouTube memberships. There are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. And of course, with any level of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to send a huge shout out to my Patreon members. Love how that group is growing. You can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.